The present poem. This is Solitary Reaper, Part 3. The Solitary Reaper is one of Wordsworth's most famous lyric. It is musical in thought and in words. The words of the Solitary Reaper's song are incomprehensible to the speaker, so his attention is free to focus on the tone, on the expressive beauty and the blissful mood it creates in him. There is, when he travels, he was fond of traveling. He loved to be in the lap of nature. So whenever he traveled, once when he was traveling, he came across a solitary reaper in the field. She was busy with her task, that is, she was doing some reaping and cutting, but at the same time, she was singing beautifully. The poet wonders whether he should listen to her or he should leave the place, but he cannot resist listening to her from at a distance. He does not know the subject matter of the music of this woman. He compares her to the most beautiful birds, and then wonders about the subject matter of the song. But what he really wishes to point out is the lasting impression that the music had on his mind, and as he traveled further, he bore the music in his heart. The poem functions to praise the beauty of the music and its fluid expressive beauty and the spontaneous overflow of powerful feelings, as Wordsworth has stated. It takes its origin from emotions recollected in tranquility, which I'll take up in detail later. And Wordsworth's philosophy was that this is the heart of poetry. The poet requests his listeners to behold a young maiden who was reaping and singing to herself. You might be wondering, as the subject describes a reaper, a woman, a human, so how can it be in keeping with the romantic tradition which worships nature? So there have been questions on this, but I told you earlier that the characteristic feature of romantic poetry was that it came down to the common man, to the common people. It did not describe nobility. Here, she is a woman, she is a solitary woman, she is working in the fields, a down-to-earth common human being. And she has been fit aptly in the lap of nature. That is what makes this poem so interesting.